Hi guys, I'm Kesha. Welcome to the channel and welcome to our coffee times. Today, even though it's Christmas, I wanted to talk to you about a movie that I kind of have mixed feelings about. That is the new movie directed by George Clooney that was just released on Netflix, The Midnight Sky.
It's coffee time.
I was actually really excited about this movie because I do like the other films that George Clooney has directed before. This is his seventh movie as a director. Especially The Monument Man from 2014 is one of my favorites. I really truly enjoyed that movie. And when I heard that he was planning this new film on Netflix that was going to be kind of like a near future post-apocalyptic story, I was extremely excited to check it out. And I was kind of, you know, satisfied but disappointed. It's kind of like a weird combination of feelings. So I thought I would sit down to talk to you guys about the film and make a spoiler-free review to tell you just what I thought of the movie in general and if it's worth your time or not. Before we jump to the review, if you love horror, if you love movies, series, and anything nerdy, collectibles, you name it, please consider subscribing to the channel before you leave and also hit the notification bell so you don't miss any more coffee times. The Midnight Sky is a PG-13 science fiction and fantasy American film directed by George Clooney based on the novel Good Morning, Midnight by Lily Brooks Dalton. This film was praised by some because of the visuals, because of the kind of attention paid to make a heartfelt film, but also it was criticized for being a little bit generic and predictable, which is why I also have mixed feelings about this film. In the film, we follow two different timelines. On the one hand, we have George Clooney and this little girl that are trying to survive isolated in the earth after a disaster happened. We don't exactly get explained how we came here, but we are in a post-apocalyptic scenario in a near future. And you know, one of the things that bothered me a little bit is that we don't get explanation on how we got there. And the other timeline is following a spaceship crew. And my problem was that these two different timelines, of course, you feel like at some point they're gonna merge. And even when they do merge, I was feeling like there was some sort of punch missing. There was something that was not there that I was expecting. And the timeline based on Clooney and the little girl is so much more interesting. And the characters are explored with a lot more depth. You actually do care about these two characters. Meanwhile, on the spaceship with the crew, you don't really get to explore them too much as characters. So you don't really end up caring too much about them. And I felt like this was a weird kind of balance, you know, between its two storylines, and it made me care way less about the space crew, you know? George Clooney plays Agustin, one of our main characters, and he is a dying scientist that was left behind at an outpost in the Arctic, and he finds this little girl that is mute, and they develop this nice relationship, and these are the two characters that I ended up caring so much about and that I wish I would have seen more of in the nearly 2 hour long film. Clooney and Springle and their relationship are one of the best parts of the film, and they did try to make a story with a lot of emotions, with a lot of character development. And the problem is that when it comes to the plot, there were a couple of interesting twists, but it kind of felt generic and predictable. So this is a movie that honestly, it is really well shot, it is well acted, it has a nice score, and it had the potential to be a great movie. However, if you take away all of those things, you are left with a plot that was lacking in a lot of areas. I think this film in general would have benefited more if it would have had a kind of a little bit of a faster pace, less running time, and if it would have focused a little bit more on the relationship of Clooney and the little girl, about their emotions, the grief, the loss, the isolation, feeling lost, all of those things, because it's those small moments that elevate the movie. And I think they were trying so hard to do something between The Martian and, you know, Interstellar, something like that, and it kind of backfired because they paid so much attention to, you know, the effects are nice and the visuals. You know, it's always good to have amazing visuals, but not if you're going to lose the plot and the characters while you're at it. There is something special about the movie, though. It has a very special heart, it has a very special feeling, and like I said, I do wish they would have focused a little bit more on the simple things and not about, you know, special effects and the Arctic and the space. And I feel like this film would have benefited if they would have aimed to make a smaller, more intense movie about more the relationship of Clooney and this little girl. I feel like they had a couple of different ideas and they wanted to make this epic movie, and the problem is that it ended up being a movie with a plot that was a little bit too predictable, too generic, and it would have been such a wonderful movie, like so, you know, intimate if they would have focused more in one story, in one timeline, and if they would have given the characters more screen time instead of giving us more of the space crew that I didn't care so much about. So, all in all, this movie, I think it's worth one watch for sure. Like I said, the visuals are good, the acting is great, the score, everything when it comes to the technicality is good, is there. But for me, the plot, like I said, was something that I lost interest in, and also I wish I would have seen more of Clooney and the little girl, and it would have been a more kind of cold, intimate movie about these two characters that are trying to survive. That would have been the movie for me, that would have made it more interesting for me. But I still feel like it's worth a watch if you are, you know, considering checking it out. So I ended up giving this movie a 2.5 out of 5 stars. Like I have said, I think the movie is really well executed, but it is lacking in a lot of departments, and that's why I only gave it 2.5. But I still recommend you guys to give it a try. Let me know down below if you have already watched the movie, if you're planning to watch it, and also let me know if you like the movies that have been directed by George Clooney. What is your input there? Do you like his work? Do you not like his work? Let's talk about it in the comments down below. Thanks so much for watching, you guys. Please give the video a big thumbs up for support. If you want to follow me on the social medias, always the links are down below, and I hope to see you all in the next coffee time. Bye!